All right, so we're continuing our discussion of the conservation of momentum. And remember, in previous videos, we obtained expressions for some of the forces on a differential fluid element. And we just began looking at the contribution due to flow. So momentum carried into and out of our control volume by flow. And so we showed that we could express that quantity in terms of this rho v times v dot n. Because remember, momentum is mass times velocity, mv. So we have kilogram meters per second per area time. So this term gives us an expression for the momentum carried into and out of the control volume by flow. So we're going to apply it to our differential control volume shown here. And so to sort of keep track of what we're doing, I'm going to make a little table here. So in the first column, I'm going to have, you know, the face of the cube that I'm talking about. And then in the next two columns, I'll have the momentum inflow and outflow through these respective faces. So if I start with the faces that have normal in the x direction, so on the left-hand side face, you know, I follow the same procedure that I've used for developing conservation of mass and also for looking at the sum of the forces. So I have the value of the momentum flux at the center, rho v times v dot n. So this is the center of the cube, and then I map that out to the face of interest, which in this case is the left-hand face. So the partial with respect to x of the quantity, rho v times v dot n, times the distance from the center to the left-hand face, which is minus delta x over 2. And I have to multiply all that times the area of this face, delta y, delta z. So I can do the same thing on the right-hand side face over here. I have the value at the center, rho v times v dot n, plus the rate of change of rho v times v dot n over x times the distance from the center to the right-hand face, delta x over 2, all multiplied times delta y, delta z. So that gives me, that maps the momentum flux from the center, the origin, to the surface of interest. So I want to point out here that v dot n, because our normal vector is in the x direction, so v dot n automatically selects the x component of the velocity vector u. So all these v dot n's are actually u for these faces that have a normal in the x direction. Okay, so I have the x component of velocity u, so I can rewrite each expression by replacing v dot n with the scalar u. So remember, that's the x component of the velocity vector. So I can do that here for each of these terms. Okay, so then I can continue this analysis. It's probably familiar by now because we've applied it several times already for the other two faces. So on the faces, the top and bottom faces that have normals in the y direction, so on the bottom I have rho v times the scalar v, which is the y component of velocity, plus the partial with respect to y of rho v times the distance from the center to the bottom face, minus delta y over 2, times the area of that face, delta x, delta z. And then I get the corresponding expression here for the top face. Then I can do the same thing for the front and the back faces. So on the back side, I have rho v times the z component of velocity, w, plus partial with respect to z of rho vw times the distance from the back face to the center, or the center to the back face, minus delta z over 2 times the area of that face, delta x, delta y. And then I have a corresponding expression here for the front face of this cube. Okay, so then I can take, you know, inflow minus outflow to get the net flow into the system. And so I notice here that, again, these terms cancel out. Rho vu cancels with this rho vu. This rho vv cancels with this rho vv. And this rho vw cancels with this rho vw. And then the other terms combine when I take inflow minus outflow. So I can add them together. So when I put all this together, I get minus partial with respect to x of rho vu minus partial with respect to y of rho v times scalar v minus partial with respect to z of rho v times w, all times delta x, delta y, delta z. Okay, so let me write that again here so I can use that as the starting point to continue. So again, I just want to point out that, you know, this V term here is the vector V, and it's multiplied by a scalar that represents the components of the velocity vector U, V, and W. Okay, so now I'm going to make some assumptions. So I'm going to assume that this is an incompressible flow, so that rho is constant. So this will allow me to factor the density out of this derivative if I assume that it doesn't change with position and space. And then I'm going to apply the chain rule, because I got to take the derivative of the vector V and also the derivative of these components, U, V, and W, in each direction. So when I do that, I get the inflow minus outflow, so the density factors out. And so I'm going to look at the first terms. I'm going to collect the first terms where I have the derivative of the vector V. So I have U times the partial of vector V with respect to X plus V, scalar V, times the partial of vector V with respect to Y, plus W times the partial of vector V with respect to Z. So that's the first part of the chain rule applied to each of these terms. Then for the second part, I have the vector V held, I hold the vector V constant, and then I have the sum of the derivatives, partial derivative of U with respect to X, plus partial derivative of V with respect to Y, plus partial derivative of W with respect to Z. And all that times delta X, delta Y, delta Z. Okay, now notice that this term may look familiar. When we talked about conservation of mass, this actually was what we got for the continuity equation for the case of incompressible flow. Right, so another way to express that, remember, in vector form is a del dot V equals zero. So for an incompressible fluid, this expression for the inflow and outflow of momentum can be simplified. So we can break this up into the individual components, because remember these are vector quantities here involved in these derivatives. So we just look at the x component. We have minus rho times u times the partial derivative with respect to x of the u of the x component of velocity u, plus v times the partial with respect to y of the x component of velocity u, plus w times the partial with respect to z of the x component of velocity u, times delta x, delta y, delta z. Then similarly, the y component of this vector term would be minus rho times u times the partial derivative with respect to x of the y component of velocity v, plus v times partial of v with respect to y, plus w times the partial of v with respect to z, times delta x, delta y, delta z. And in the z direction, we get minus rho times u times the partial with respect to x of the z component of velocity w, plus v times the partial with respect to y of w, plus w times the partial with respect to z of w, times delta x, delta y, delta z. So this collection of terms, either in vector form or in terms of the individual components, represents the contribution to the momentum balance due to inflow and outflow of momentum into the control volume. And so now we have just about everything we need to complete the momentum balance. We have the sum of the forces, and we have the expression for the inflow and outflow. So now we just got to put it all together into Newton's second law, and we should be able to get the conservation of momentum expression that we need.